Oh, hi viewers, welcome to another Rambling episode with your host, Gildem. That's me. Here to talk about thoughts and whatever. I need to ventilate, because, you know, that's what I'm doing here, that's what I do. You, the viewers, watching, you guys are probably just chilling out, not really sure. Anyone who doesn't know, you know, come on in, listen to what I have to say, and write in the comment section, because you're essentially my counselor. This is counseling in like half an hour or something like that. Use the comment section as clipboard. Write your thoughts, write your analysis, be like, Gildem, you're a whack job, or Gildem, I can relate to this one section. And you know, we'll all be happy, and I'll reply. For some reason, though, like, some of my comments get marked as spam, and I don't understand why, because it's like, you know, people, they write the thing, and I'm perfectly fine with them writing the thing, even if it's, like, short, or even if it's, like, something that's really insignificant. It means a lot to me. Honestly, I wouldn't like mark it for spam. For some reason, YouTube does that. So if that ever happens, I try to approve it just because. What's the point? You know, I don't care. I'm just kind of going off on my head. I'm going off on my thoughts and ideas in my head. You guys shouldn't have to be censored either, right? No one should be censored. Can we agree with that? But for some reason, YouTube's like, oh, it's spam! Anyways, I don't know where I'm going with this. I have some points that I need to talk about. I have my top 10 list that I was gonna bring up in this part, because it's important. And I was gonna talk about my top 3 sections. But before that, allow me to tell you something, because I fucked up. I don't know how I did this, but I screwed up my own top 10 list. Because, I find ways to do that. I know, you think it should be impossible, because it's like, it's your top 10 list, Gildem. You can't screw your top 10 list up. How did you even manage that? I don't know, let's just call it an impressive feat. Because, you know, I managed to find ways to amaze people. That's what I'm gonna chalk it up to. I managed to find some way that you figured would not be able to be screwed up, you know. Legitimately, you figure it would be like on my brain just like 24/7, be like, here's my top 10, allow me to reiterate from 10 to 1. But nope, I managed to skip the sixth title. I managed to skip that for some reason. So allow me to restate the top 10 in all its glory. We'll get into the top 3. Maybe I'll try to explain all the other titles. But I'm trying not to oversaturate this video with just that one topic, because I have other things I need to talk about. So, Gildem's top 10 may be subjected to change. But, title number 10, Tetris. Title number 9, Final Fantasy VII. Title number 8, Resident Evil 2. Title number 7, The Warriors. Title number 6, Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker. Number 5, Lisa, the Painful RPG, with the Joyful DLC, because it's just an extension of the story, you know, it's just continuing what's going on. Anyways, point is, number 4, Donkey Kong Country, number 3, Binding of Isaac, number 2, Parasite Eve, and number 1, Evo, The Search for Eden. Oh man, I did it! All 10 titles, all 10, Gildem's top favorite 10 games that he played and he enjoys and he thinks of fondly and he has fun playing them, and sometimes he plays some of them yearly and sometimes he doesn't. Oh man. Okay, so originally in the last part, in the last rambling part, I said I was going to talk about my top 3, but before I get into that, and I might digress and I might not get into it, so forgive me if I don't, I have to bring up another topic. I have to digress to a completely different subject, because I might oversaturate the video trying to attempt to explain things. I'm terrible at that shit, so forgive me, viewers. I don't exactly want to just saturate the video with and because my brain, it doesn't always work the way that I want to, and sometimes there's a pause trying to get to the next topic. I like to be entertaining. I like to have a fluent motion. Sometimes it's a little spastic. Sometimes I like to take sips to kind of help with my throat. It helps. Sometimes I take throat lozenges for that. Anyways, allow me to try to make a thing that I had to do. First off, I've been using my Twitter a lot more. Because, you know, Gildem, he has a Twitter. He uses it. He makes posts on it. Didn't really use it a whole lot. But at the same time, I've been using it a bit more. It's been great. I'm glad that I'm actually getting through and making sure to use it. Chaz is there. Another one of our friends is there. So it's great. And, you know, I've been posting a bit more. I made a post recently. You guys can go check that out. I'm sure in the title, or no, not in the title. Why would it be in the title? In the description, there'll be a link to my Twitter. Maybe somewhere on screen, there's one of those cards, because YouTube has this new thing. Instead of annotations, now you got cards. It shows up as the little eye in the corner. I didn't know about that. I've seen it, but I didn't realize that's what that was. Anyways, you know, going into it, looking at it, that's something that's really cool, and, you know, I learned something. Point is, I have a Twitter, I use it, I have to make a shout-out to one of my friends who gave me a box of games and, consoles. Mainly, like, the gen- what is it, I think it's either the 5th or 6th. I'm gonna say 6th. That sounds about right. Either way, if that's completely wrong, it's the generation that had, like, the original Xbox, the PlayStation 2, and the GameCube. Basically, he just gave me a box that's full of, like, stuff from that generation. Cords, games, systems, controllers. Basically, I got a bunch of stuff that I can use for this channel. He made a donation, and I wanted to give him a shout-out. He's also the guy that I've been talking a lot in previous videos, the one that's moving to North Carolina. So, I wanted to give him a shout out. I'll probably link him to this video, or I'll probably give him a link just so like he can see this and I can hear that I actually was thanking him. I wanted to make it official because I respect him, man. And you know what, again, really, really proud of the guy. Really glad that he's actually trying to do something very, very, Now I'm getting all sentimental. I can't think straight. Oh, man. Sorry, bro. My point is, I'm really proud of you. It's not easy doing what you're doing, but at the same time, you're making it work. And it takes a lot of courage, a lot of guts to actually just pick up, move to a new state. Let alone going from, like, one end of the country to the far other side. It's crazy. But at the same time, I'm always here rooting for you. I would help you move, but that's a little difficult for me to actually just do that, you know. I'd have to take time off from work to even manage that. And I already got my vacation time planned, so sorry, bro. That said, I'm here. I'm here for support. So that's my thankful segment for my guy. And you know what? I also have to say something else because he's not the first person who's made donations. Oh no, I actually have two donations that I failed to think about. Because, you know, Gildem, he gets donations. I can't believe it. I get donations. I get donations from people for the channel. The Wolf Among Us, that was actually a gift from Spider Mikey. So I'm gonna say he donated to the channel. I made a Let's Play, and you know what? It's there. I completed it. It's all there. It took me a year to get through that, because for some reason, 2016, that was a really awkward year, just like 2015. Let's just chalk it up to I've been going through some emotional shit or something. I don't know. I can't think of a better term. So that's what I'm gonna say about that. There I go, making a bunch of us. Because I can't talk straight. I'm having trouble trying to think of the next topic. I guess you could just chalk that up to my transitional noise. It's one of those, one of the things that I brought up. You guys know what I'm talking about. Anyways. So aside from that, I also have another donation. Now, something I have not showed on the channel. I was thinking about the best way to get this, like, put on the channel. Because originally, I had a co-worker who started watching my stuff, and, you know, I miss the guy. But at the same time, like, he left, he quit, he went on to better things. And, you know, I respect that. Because my job, not always the easiest thing to get into. But anyways, he got me a game. And it was a game that not a lot of people did. And at the time, I don't think there was any actual Let's Plays. I think somebody did something. I think somebody actually did do a video. Like, they actually attempted a Let's Play. So I think there's something now, but that said, I don't see a lot of videos really, like, doing anything for this, this game. So, I was thinking, as my next rambling segment, so to speak, I mean, the segment's not really changing, but the game will. I was thinking that I would do this game, or at least attempt it, or at least have a couple parts showing it off. And I think that would be an accurate way to really go through it, and you guys could see it, and we could talk about it, because it's based off of something, believe it or not. And it's something that I do have things to say, because, you know, it's a show I grew up with. If none of you know what I'm talking about, we'll tackle it when that time comes. So I'm going to save all that for then. But my point is, my friend made this donation. I never got around to it. I feel bad. I should. And you know what? I think I have the perfect time to actually tackle it. So when that time comes, I will give him a huge thank you. I'll give him a huge shout out. He has a YouTube channel, but I don't think he does anything on it. I think it's just for one of those, like, viewer-like channels. You know, you make an account, then you go talk about this. Or, like, you know, you favorite videos, you like videos, and then you comment on videos. You know, typical stuff. Typical non-creator content channel. I have nothing wrong with that. None at all. My point is, I will give him a shout-out on that channel. And I will, like, link those videos when they come out so that he knows that I'm doing the thing that I should have been doing all along. And hopefully he'll be proud of me. I would be, like, thankful if he's like, oh man, you're doing this? I don't know. I'd be thankful if he just, like, bats an eye, to be honest. Because I owe it to him. I owe it to him. Oh man. So, I had to talk about donations, because people have actually contributed to the channel, and you know what? I don't want to sound like I'm not grateful. I really am. I appreciate anyone who's trying to help the channel grow, because, you know, it's like, who really pays attention to me? You know, it's like, I'm lucky if I get anybody who views any of my things here, things that I do. You know, and I'm grateful for that. But at the same time, like, people actually trying to support me is amazing. I can't believe it. I never thought I'd have any support. You know, here, along the lines, it's always just been me. And I never thought that I'd make it big. In fact, I haven't. But if I ever did, I don't know, I'd make a t-shirt or something. that said, it's just one of those things where it's like, people are supporting me, and I'm grateful, and I can't believe people actually contribute. But oh my god, I'm so grateful. Thank you friends, thank you family, friends. I am grateful, I do appreciate it. Alright, moving on to other things, because as much as I can constantly keep going us and this and that, I also have things that I need to discuss, like my top three. And also, you know what? I have to go hang out with a friend. Because for some reason, I'm super popular. I've been hanging out with a lot of people, and I can't believe I've been hanging out with a lot of people. Like, I hung out with two people yesterday at different times. I'm hanging out with a friend within an hour, essentially, from recording this. I have to go to the store real quick. So that's exciting. And furthermore, I have a friend that I'm hanging out with tomorrow. And the other day I was thinking to myself, Gildem, how did you become so popular? This is ridiculous. You're like the most social introvert. That friend pointed that out to me. I didn't even think about it, but apparently I'm a social introvert, and I didn't even think that was possible because it's like an oxymoron. It's like, how can you be sociable and an introvert? They don't really go well together. But I guess it can be socially awkward, which I'd accept, right? Can everyone accept that? Socially awkward? I feel socially awkward. I feel like I don't do well in society, and you know, whatever I say, it's super awkward. For instance, this one girl, she was like, have a good morning. You know, one of my coworkers, she's pretty cute. But it totally caught me off guard, because I was like, oh, you too. You know, and it's one of those things where it's like, she baffled me. I wasn't expecting that, you know. I was trying to go home. I wasn't feeling well. Like, one, like something, a box, like, broke open. And it smelled like vinegar, like really, really strong vinegar. It made me really nauseous. I was feeling sick for at least a good, like, 2-3 hours. And it was not a good situation, so I was just focused on leaving. And, you know, kind of trying to get some Pepto-Bismol or something, you know? Because I don't want to feel nauseous. No one does. It's not a good situation. But at the same time, you know, if you catch me as I'm walking out with an upset stomach, or just feeling nauseous, because I don't know if upset stomach and nauseous are, like, two of the same thing. I feel like nauseousness has a little bit more to it. You know, my point is my mind's kind of focused on that, not really trying to be social. And, you know, for some reason, everyone wants to be social around me, and it's weird. I'm just thinking to myself, I'm the socially awkward person, but everyone wants to talk to me, and everyone wants to hang out with me. And it's not even a curse, because I would never say, woe is me. It's just one of those things where it's like, this is weird. When did I become so popular? When did everyone want to hang out with me? And as I was telling Spider Mikey the other day, because I hung out with him, he was one of the four people that I mentioned, usually if something like this happens, because it's not like this hasn't, it just doesn't happen very often, usually if it does, I get hugely introverted. Like, all the tendencies of being introverted just hits me, like, super hard, and then just all of a sudden, don't want to deal with anything. I just want to be locked up in my room, just like, hiding out, just kind of chilling, just being like, yeah, yeah, now I just gotta absorb all the social essence, you know? I gotta work myself up to being back to social man, awkward pants. I can't think of a better way to phrase things. I'm terrible at it. But I still try. I still make content for the channel. Man, wasn't I gonna talk about my top 10? Alright, you know what? Let's transition to a completely different topic, because I was gonna talk about my top 3 choices. But I feel like I can't do that without talking about all 10 games again, because, you know, last time I was trying to, missed out on talking about number 6, which is unfortunate, because, you know, as someone who grew up with any of the Legend of Zelda titles, I feel like you have to talk about the Legend of Zelda, because, you know, it's so influential. Just like my number 9 and number 8, Final Fantasy 7 and Resident Evil 2. Because I like those series. Those are great series. I don't care what anyone says. I'm still following those series strong, even to today. To make a point, you know what I just got? I got Resident Evil 7! I'm holding the case in my hand. I'm shaking it. If you guys can hear that, that's Resident Evil 7. Oh man, I can't wait to play that. I was thinking about getting a PlayStation VR sometime in the near future, but I don't know. I don't think I can actually, like hook that up to the computer. If I can, I mean, could you imagine Gildem looking like a fool while doing some VR? Jesus Christ. I think the internet would break. Or my whole channel would break. I feel like YouTube would just say, no, no. Don't need a fat man getting tripped over everything in his room, breaking the walls, causing drywall damage. Ugh. You know, it just seems like too much work. I don't want to do safe. Look, when I become the Kool-Aid Man, yeah, when I become Kool-Aid Man and start busting through walls, I think I've gone too far. Anyways, so I talked about my top 10, and I was trying to get to that. I'm trying to, viewers, you just gotta bear with me, because, you know, it's tough talking about 10 things and attempting to just explain why all 10 are, like, awesome, and why Gildem likes these and holds them dearly. So allow me to try to go through this really quick until we get to the top three. Okay, so you got Tetris. Let me tell you something about Tetris. Tetris is a fun game. I like it. I like puzzle games. I like Dr. Mario. I like Yoshi's Cookies. I like, Catherine. I can call Catherine, because, I can call Catherine, man. She's totally awesome. I know. I like Catherine, because it's a fun puzzle game. It came out in the near future. I'm failing to think of other puzzle games. A lot of them are really good. Tetris Attack, Pokemon League, those are pretty much the same thing, right? Anyways, point is, I like puzzle games. I like using my mind. I like trying to, like, match up things. I have OCD tendencies, bro. So, you know what's amazing? Getting a Tetris. You know, you put blocks on top of blocks, just so when you get the long four-segment block, you just slide it on down, and it goes so perfectly, and you feel accomplished. And it just hits you where the OCD tendencies are all, like, making you giddy, and you get that warm, fuzzy feeling, which was what I was trying to say, because Gildem is trying to, like, sort it out his million thoughts right now. So it's really tough to actually just get them all in order. They're jumping around like a preschool, kindergarten class, lion thing. I don't know. I'm thinking of an analogy. My mind is failing on analogies. I think I talked about 9 and 8. But before I move on, allow me to also phrase something. Aside from being amazing games, because, I mean, anyone can claim that Final Fantasy VII and Resident Evil 2 are amazing games, they have a lot going for them, and they're fantastic. But allow me to also say that, at a young age, they had some psychological shit I could not handle. You got Resident Evil 2 with the liquor, right? And you got Final Fantasy VII with Headless Genova scene, along with that one experimental soldier thing, which I don't really know, but I always chalked it up to the guys that were in the black capes. That's what those things were. They were like the guys from the pods. They were that genetics experiment with the soldier and like the Genova cells, and it was really, really messed up. But you know what? I like that shit. I like it. I like human experimentation on a storyline because it's so creative. And how far people are messed up, but I like that. So much so that it kind of goes in line with Parasite Eve, but I'll try to talk about that subject when the time comes. I gotta get through this list. I like really bizarre things like that, because it's so creative and it's so twisted that it's just intriguing, or at least intrigues me, because I'm always like, what are they doing with this? Where are they going? What kind of monstrosity have they made? This Frankenstein abomination. It's just so weird, but at the same time, I can't turn away. I need to know exactly what they were trying to do. And I like the theme that I like that as a sci-fi element that's very prevalent in Final Fantasy VII. And I also like Resident Evil 2, where, you know, that's the basis. That's the basis for the Umbrella Corporation. They made zombies through this one virus experiment to create a super soldier, so to speak. And you know what? They created tyrants, and they created nemesis, and you know what? Like, furthermore, the liquor? Not even a planned B.O.W. It was just like this mutation from the T-virus that was completely unexpected, but it happened. And you know what? Even to today, it traumatized me, because my mind could not handle what the hell I was looking at such a young age. But at the same time, you know what? It was one of those things where it did a 180 as I grew up. Instead of being horrified and still having nightmares, mind you. I have nightmares about the liquor. I can't explain it. It traumatized me on that level. Point is, I find that stuff very interesting. You know, I really dig that shit. Because I can't turn away. I get intrigued. I get giddy whenever I see that. Not because I like it, just because it's one of those things where it's like, man, this is a very interesting subject. It's like, I know it's really messed up, but at the same time, I like to see where they're going with this. Because it's like, when humanity goes so far that it's so messed up, it's just kind of interesting to see this train wreck fell, but at the same time, where they're going with it. I like it. I don't know where I'm going with this other than that. I mean, that's really all I can say. I gotta move on. The Warriors. I like the Warriors. That movie's amazing. Ajax is like my hero, man. And then you got Coach Ace, which I've always been a fan of that guy because he always seems like, you know, he's not strong, but at the same time, he can land quite a few punches very quickly. He's always been that type of guy, in my opinion. Point is, I like those two guys. They're like my favorite Warriors. I root for them every time they're on screen. Not so much of a fan of Swan, but at the same time, I would never, like, disobey Swan's orders, because he's smart, and I feel bad for Cleon. But you know what? The movie doesn't really cover too much on Cleon. You know what does? The game. The game is amazing. It's just an extension of the universe that is portrayed by the movie, and even the book, to that degree. Because there's a book, if you can believe it. I never really read it, but at the same time, I always meant to, because it looks really good. I'm not gonna lie. I mean, the book, it's the book that inspired the movie, which inspired the game. All this said, I'm not really into brawlers, but let me tell you something. I'd totally dig the hell out of it. And you know what? I have a lot of fun playing it. There's not really much else to say other than I have fun playing it. And I like hearing the story unfold. And really, when it comes down to it, a game story can really just, like, bypass a lot of things that you wouldn't normally delve into. I'm not much into brawlers, but at the same time, I have a lot of fun playing them. I have a lot of fun playing the Warriors. And I have a lot of fun trying to pull off combos, because I suck at those. But you know what? The Warriors makes it fun for even an amateur like myself. Also, the fact that you have Rumble mode, where you can just basically pick and match all the characters introduced, doesn't hurt. I like that shit. So, the Warriors. Great story, even better game, in my opinion. Oh man. So, I'm gonna skip Legend of Zelda, because I feel like that's a video in another part, you know. I can be here for hours just explaining why The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker is amazing, but I have to compare other titles if I was going to do that, especially Majora's Mask, because let me tell you something. Majora's Mask was my favorite up until I played The Wind Waker. Dropping back to a simple time, that's all I'll say right now. As for Lisa, the painful RPG, I'm gonna save that also for another time, because let me tell you something. If I'm gonna talk about Lisa, I gotta talk about, like, Undertale and Earthbound, which, those are very interesting topics. I feel like I'm gonna offend someone no matter how I try to pull that one off. So, I'll save that one for later. Those are two long discussion, probably 30 minutes, just gonna take up the whole entire part. I apologize. In fact, these last three, well, aside from Donkey Kong Country, which I'll get through that right now. So Donkey Kong Country, I play that every year. I have a lot of fun playing it. It brings me back to nostalgia, but even more so, I like the fact that it's a game you can just pick up, play, have a lot of fun doing it, play solo or bring your buddy. And you know what? I might actually have future plans with a new co-commentator of all things, if you can believe that. Pretty amazing, am I right? So yeah, I might be having some Donkey Kong Country in the future with someone you don't even know. That said, Donkey Kong Country is also just a really fun game in the sense that I like exploring all these little hidden things that you can find. You know, you take a barrel to a wall, all of a sudden you find a bonus room that it's like, man, I didn't even know this was here. I have fun doing that. It makes me feel accomplished because it's like, I didn't know this was here. Well, now I do. And there's a whole bunch of that just scattered throughout levels. And it's one of those things that really rewards the player for taking a chance. You know, there might be a ledge. There might be like a pit. And you're like, man, this pit is very seductive because I feel like something's hidden. And you know what? Sometimes it rewards the player for actually taking that chance. Oftentimes there's a tell, but you know, also, there's walls that you can break. There's a whole bunch of rooms that you can do. There's an infinite level, or there's an infinite life glitch. And it's fun. They hide a lot of stuff. Donkey Kong Country 2, honestly, is on steroids, and it's a much improved version of the original Donkey Kong. But it takes a lot more effort to get into that game, and so I always go to the original, because it's just fun to play, and it's short enough that I can usually beat it within a time span of like 2 to 3 hours. Also, the minecart level is stupid. It's ridiculous. But I digress. Something else I gotta talk about when it comes to Donkey Kong Country. I didn't realize this, but apparently, if you bring in, like, your girlfriend or ex-girlfriend to play Donkey Kong Country, I didn't realize it's a game that can upset people, because that happened to me. I was like, hey, babe, you wanna go play some Donkey Kong Country? And she was, like, totally for it. But then, turns out, she got pissed off. And, there was other reasons associated with that, which I'm not going to get into. The point is, I realized, if I'm going to date someone, they gotta be down with Donkey Kong Country. For now, I'm just going to leave it like I broke up with my ex, because, we didn't get along with Donkey Kong Country. You guys can totally think that. It's not the reason. It's a really fucked up situation. Really, really tragic story, and I learned more about relationships in that relationship. But my point is, things I never thought I had to put on a list of, relationship stuff. Or, like, things I never thought I'd have to put on a list of, like, the person having to do. Which is get along and, like, have fun playing Donkey Kong Country. Because it's one of those games I want to play, and sometimes I want to go co-op. And so, you know, two-player mode, you know, I need my number two. And so someone who wants to play it but can't get into it, I don't know, I don't think I can deal with that. You know, there's a saying, it's not like Donkey Kong. And you know what? If you can't get it on like Donkey Kong, why should I deal with that? Why should I deal with that? Aw, man. I didn't even get to my number three, top three. I was going to talk about, like, The Binding of Isaac, how it has, like, religious tones and at a younger age, like, it can be detrimental if not handled right, you know, because religion is a tough thing. And Binding of Isaac, I think, also handles, that concept. It's a very heavy concept. And then you got Parasite Eve, which I brought up, you know, it has that weird, experimentation, or at least the second one does. First one is just, like, it has a lot of scientific terms, which I find really interesting, like evolution and mitochondria, and like this weird forced evolution, which is actually pretty creepy. But the game is, I find the game has more sci-fi elements than actual horror elements, but at the same time, like the sci-fi elements create the byproduct of horror, which I think is great. And then, you know, you got even the Search for Eden, which is just animals, and as anyone knows, I like animals, and it also dwells into, like, prehistory, and, like, you got prehistoric creatures, and even, like, ancient creatures, whatever. I'm losing my voice, and I gotta cut the video. So, for all intents and purposes, next time, I don't even know. I'll talk about top three or something. I don't know. I'll probably go into that detailed list. Maybe I'll talk about my ex. It's a video where I have topics that I may discuss. I didn't even get to the point that I was trying to do in this rambling video. I just went off topic and completely digressed to anything. But you know what? These rambling videos are completely unscripted. They have no semblance of order. And you know what? I'm fine with digressing, because I gotta ventilate. And that's what I do. I ventilate. And that's what I did. Anyways, I'm gonna end the video here. I will talk to you guys later. I gotta go hang out with a friend.